Space Quarters, a Japanese space startup founded in 2022, is on a mission to expand the potential of humanity. They plan to do that by building next-generation space construction systems that enable on-site assembly of large orbital and lunar structures. Traditional methods of orbital construction build pre-assembled structures on the ground, launch them into space, and dock them together. This was the way the International Space Station was assembled. The problem with that way is every structure must be able to fit within the payload fairing of a rocket, which limits the size of space structures that can be built. Space Quarters, similar to various other startups in the in-space assembly and manufacturing sector, plan to launch modular materials and autonomously assemble them in space. In the case of Space Quarters, using an in-house developed welding robot system, this approach reduces costs and enables creation of megastructures in space. They're working with various Japanese organizations on joint projects. Companies like IHI Aerospace, which build the solid rocket boosters for the H3 rocket, plus the reaction control systems for the second stage. Obayashi Corporation is another partner. This company is also interested in large space structures. They proposed an ambitious space elevator for Earth in the past. This partnership is focused on advanced materials and modular space construction. Recently, Space Quarters raised $5 million in seed funding, which will help the development of their electron beam welding system. The funding will help with expanding their team, installing and upgrading test and verification facilities. The company has already completed on-the-ground tests of their core technologies, switching their focus now to system-level development in preparation for a future launch to test their technology in space. Let's talk about the ISAM market, or the in-space assembly and manufacturing sector. ISAM, the growing in-space assembly and manufacturing sector. The CEO of Space Quarters said on their company website that space development has reached a major turning point in recent years. With the growth of the commercial sector, new private space stations soon to be launched, and the Artemis program to explore and settle the moon and then later Mars, he believes that humanity is at the dawn of a new era in space. He goes on to say that it's crucial to develop more infrastructure in space. He wants to see large bases in space and the creation of a transport and service network that connects them together. However, that isn't possible at the moment because the cost of construction in space is too high. Only relatively small structures can be assembled in space due to the mass and volume constraints on today's launches. Changing the paradigm of building structures on Earth and transporting and docking them in space to assembling the structures in space directly will unlock new possibilities for building megastructures in space. On this channel, I've talked about gigawatt data centers in space recently. Larger facilities are, on the whole, more cost-efficient than smaller ones. From space-based solar power satellites to massive data centers, communication antennas to orbiting space stations, space-based assembly would unlock new capabilities for these and many more facilities. Electron beam welding, the preferred method for welding in space. The core concept for Space Quarters is launching construction materials into space and then assembling them into vast structures. But how do they plan to connect all those separate pieces? The answer is by using electron beam welding. Flat packing sheets of construction material is the most volume-efficient use of today's payload fairings. In the coming years, Blue Origin's New Glenn and SpaceX's Starship vehicles should be launching on a regular basis, allowing for huge amounts of materials to be stationed in orbit. In the case of Starship, the interior volume is over 1,000 cubic meters, more than the volume of the International Space Station. Before we get into the details of their welding system, why did they choose electron beam welding? Well, it has some unique advantages in space in comparison to other welding techniques. First, welds are deep, clean, and strong, an important consideration given the pressure differentials between the inside and outside of a pressurized habitat. Second, orbital debris is an ever-present danger, so strong welds help the station withstand orbital impactors. Electron beam welding requires a vacuum to operate, a problem on Earth, but not in space with low Earth orbit close to a perfect vacuum. Electron beam welding is compatible with the typical metal structures used in space, such as titanium, aluminium, and stainless steel. It's worth noting, in passing, that cutting up a landed starship on the moon, which is made of stainless steel, would result in 80 tons of metal that could be used to assemble habitats and other structures. And finally, electron beam welding uses less energy than arc or laser welding. Their robot system is called DAC system. It's their space construction robot system. Assembly robot. From the graphic on their website, we can see a number of assembly robots that are moving and placing hexagonal construction sheets in preparation for welding them together. Welding robot. In this graphic, we can see two robots traveling along the joints of the panels, welding and inspecting the welds. Welding verification results. The company has verified their robotic system works on the ground already. In this photo, we can see the results of two sheets. One is a titanium alloy and the other is an aluminium alloy. Both show a clean weld. Space Quarters mentions on their website that non-metal and regolith bonding technology can be used for lunar construction. The electron beam welding robot should work equally as well on the moon as space, since the moon has practically no atmosphere. Although special care must be taken to protect against dust intrusion, as moon dust is electrostatically charged and abrasive. The ecosystem, competitors, partners, funding and supply chain. Space Quarters has one direct competitor, a company I've covered on this channel already, think Orbital. They also plan to build large structures in space using autonomous robots and electron beam welding. Less directly, but in the same in-space assembly and manufacturing sector, are a number of other space startups. Gitai, for example, have built robotic arms for performing assembly tasks in space or on the moon. Their dual robotic arms have been tested inside and outside the International Space Station. Gitai is a potential partner for Space Quarters, as their dual-arm lunar rovers can disassemble obsolete landers, cutting them up to be forged into new sheet metal, which can then be welded by Space Quarters robots. Icarus Robotics is a new space startup working on carrying out logistic tasks on orbit, specifically the International Space Station. It turns out highly specialized astronauts spend most of their time packing or unpacking cargo from capsules, instead of doing valuable scientific work. Icarus wants to design and build autonomous robots that can do the grunt work, freeing up astronauts for more valuable tasks. Icarus could potentially collaborate with Space Quarters on some logistical tasks. And finally, Rendezvous Robotics, with the most exotic proposal for in-space assembly, self-assembling robots that can create large structures without any welding at all. The company makes small tiles that have powerful permanent magnets, sensors and computing that can sense nearby tiles, automatically connecting to build large structures. They have tested these tiles on the International Space Station a number of times already, with a larger test of 32 dinner plate sized tiles due to be launched to the station in 2026. Upcoming events. The newly secured $5 million in seed funding helps prepare the startup for an in-space and lunar demonstration mission scheduled for 2027 to 2028. Space Quarters is targeting its first commercial deployment within the decade. What do you think of Space Quarters' idea of using autonomous robots to assemble large space structures using electron beam welding? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.